listening to focus on subcultures we can find in our city, in Rimini. And we also included some pictures to make you understand better the presentation. Okay, so first of all, we want to give you a definition of subculture. Subculture is a subset of cultural elements, so age, social class, religious or political beliefs, and so on, that distinguishes a particular group of people's attitudes from those of a global society. Each subculture is often defined in opposition to the values of the widespread culture that surrounds it. As I said before, we decided to focus on the subcultures in Rimini. So we included Rastafarians, skaters, otakus, writers, metalheads, and gutter punks. Okay, so the first one is the otaku. Otaku is a Japanese term for a subculture obsessed with mangas, animes, and other products related to them. In Western culture, the term is used to refer to both specifically fans of Japanese comics and animated cartoons, and people in general, keen on whatever comes from Japan. In Europe, the term has the negative connotation it has in its homeland. Here the question is, what do you find your membership from? The way I dress and from my personal tastes in general. Japanese school uniforms for girls, so they wear baby shoes, dark blue skirts, Parisian stockings and white shirts, and for boys, sweatshirts that recall video games or mangas. And in general, both girls and boys highlight a childish look. They wear a long hair for girls and short for boys, and for all straight and colorful. They listen to Miku, which is a virtual singer created through a computer but with a real voice. They usually dress up as cosplay, reading comics, for example, Fairy Tail or One Piece, and they watch animes, which are Japanese cartoons. And they often meet in comic fairs like Rimini Comics, Luca Comics, or Romics. This is our friend Valentina. As you can see, she has straight and long and colorful hair, and she wears a colorful t-shirt. Next, we have Gutter Punk. They reject any socially accepted behavior for political or purely personal reasons. Their look is often characterized by a combination of different styles that appeal to hip-hop and punk. They wear loose clothing for both women and men, glove DC and loose shoes, and their hair are shaved, colored, and holes. And they have piercings and tattoos. They listen to techno, goa, and Frenchcore, and many of them hang out to a rave world. They live symbiotically with dogs, for example, pit bulls, Rottweilers, or bull terriers, and they often meet in parks and arcades of the city. Here, as you can see, the large trousers, their shoes, and the dog they live with. And here, there's another example. Okay, so here we have metalheads, which are fans of metal band music like AC/DC or Metallica, and Deep Purple, and Sevenfold, Rammstein, so on, which are famous for music genres like rock music and heavy metal. Okay, and they wear boots and large jeans, and they usually wear long hair for men, and women usually wear short hair, and they usually have some tattoos on their body. They
there. They used to go to band concerts and Egyptian bands, drink beer, and they like to go to motorcycle rallies. And here we have one example: long hair, black long hair. And next we have skaters, which is a sport which is born in, which was born in America, but it has such a long, such a big spread, and it became a sport and a way of living, which is common with our youth lifestyle. And they wear long hair and sweatshirt, narrow black pants. They usually wear some hat and a backpack and also red shoes. They listen to dubstep and metal, hardcore and punk rap. Yeah, they use skateboards and for moving to one place to another. Yeah, as a means of transport. And they meetings are in skate parks and urban centers, as you can see here.
Okay, next we have writers. The writer illegally paints urban graffitis on train wagons or on walls using spray. And in recent years, the government has relied on writers to improve the degraded urban areas. They wear baggy pants, sweatshirts, and loose knees, caps, and tattoos. They listen to hip hop and rap, and they act overnight. And they always meet in community centers. Here you can see the colors they use to paint the spray. And here you can see the baggy pants and a guy who is painting on a wall.
And here we have Rastafarians, which due their name to the emperor of Ethiopia, Rastafari, which names last July, as you can see here. Millions of people recognize this emperor as the head of Rastafarian church, so for them it's very important. Since the 18th century, from the 18th, the Rasta culture has spread from Jamaica to the rest of the world, thanks to Bob Marley and Peter Tosh. They believe in the equality of rights, and they reject war. Plus they believe in liberal, democratic, and political systems. Based on the Declaration of Human Rights. The music taste is based on listening to reggae and roots and dub and jungle. And they use marijuana, which is called ganja, and because they believe that ganja is something that could get them closer to divinity and could produce inner peace and meditation. They have dreadlocks, which is a hairstyle, which are not in hair wisps, like you can see here, and they are sometimes they are decorated with rings, and they wear hats which are which could be colored with the color of Jamaica, which are green, yellow, and red. As you can see here, the hat and the decoration on the hair. And okay, so a special thanks to our friends Marco and Valentina, which